Okay, well, we definitely need to sleep because we had a hell of a stressful week. Okay, apparently I'm not doing that yet. Happy Thanksgiving!
Huh? But it's Columbus.
No! It's not that day. Not here.
Why not?
That guy caused a lot of trouble. We don't say his name.
He who shall not be named.
My fault. I should have told you guys earlier. The way the native people and the newcomers mixed out is a little different than it is for the non-magical history. We have strong ties, is what my mom says. Sacred smoke takes, like, a fourth of all the magical students in the U.S., and around here, the local spirits were dealing with them way before us. So a lot of our rituals and celebrations come from them.
So this is Thanksgiving?
Not really, I was kidding. It's Canadian Thanksgiving.
Oh, very true. October 14th.
You're Southern, so you don't notice it as much.
Oh.
Anyway, what should I do this week? Sleep. And... I don't know. What, red, blue, white? I mean, I keep thinking the paw print is white. Green and black. Yes, we'll do it like that. Yay, no more stress. Woohoo, 2 magic. Ah, breeze. Cost 1 mana. Moves air around the caster's current square, creating a gentle breeze. Sounds useful on a hot day, maybe? 1 blue magic. Oh, all of a sudden it's Thursday. Diagnosis. 1 mana. Determines the current state of health of a living target and locates ailments and injuries. Oh, 2 black magic. Inscription. Write or remove words from a target object. What's the point of that? Oh, at least something finally happened. That week just went, like, flew by like that. I'm alone in my room when I hear a knock on the door. Oh. Oh, I've never done you. Minne. I don't know what to do.
Hello, cutie.
Hi.
I'm just making the rounds to invite everyone to the Saturday study sessions. If you need help with any of your classes, I'll be available in the library on Saturdays.
Thanks, weirdo. Weirdo voice.
Okay, bye.
She hurries off. Well, that happened. On Saturday morning, I get up terribly early and deliver the mail and the allowances. Then I'm free for the day. What should I do today? I'll study. Oh, this is new. Compared to the rest of the school, the library is fairly small and unimpressive. There's a slightly outdated set of encyclopedias. Ellen didn't really need to bring her own. And a good collection of foreign language dictionaries. Plus, 2 bookcases filled with books about magic and witchy history. Most of the rest looks like fiction, with a rack of popular magazines. The school actually subscribes to those? There aren't that many people in here on a Saturday, but looking around I see.
Hi, cutie. Do you need help with anything?
Well, sure, why don't ya? Might as well take advantage of it. Minnie helps me out with my white magic. Huh. And I got smarter. Nice. Wow, what a week. I think, that passed by in like 3 minutes? Canadian Thanksgiving. Apparently, Columbus is a taboo subject in the magical world. Virginia says witches and wizards aren't even supposed to say his name. He's just that guy, or you know who. Therefore, this is not You Know Who Day. And then, helpful Minnie. Minnie gave me some tips on spellcasting. Wow, thrill a minute this week. Well, hopefully next week we'll have a little more action. We can hope. Hey guys, I just thought I should warn you, the next exam is Friday. Oh, this is the exam I'm supposed to fail. I hope it's worth it. I finally got my merits to zero, and I don't think Grabby likes it when I have negative merits or demerits.
But the end of the month isn't until next week.
Don't look at me, I don't make the rules. Will it be like the first one? Nothing doing. This time they drop us in a pit full of alligators and we have to fight our way out.
You are such a liar.
Aw, that sounded cool. It's not a lie if it's funny. Yeah, but do you know anything real?
Well, I'm pretty sure.
Oh, sorry. I keep mixing the two up. Well, I'm pretty sure we'll be in the dungeons, because pretty much all the exams are, but I don't know what they're going to make us do. William said that after the first time, we have to cast real spells we've learned in class, so we can't just fake it with wild magic. So we'd better know enough spells. What should I do this week? Learn some spells. We're going to do all the magic classes. Done. Woohoo! I didn't learn a spell though. Still didn't learn a spell. Oh, 3 green magic. Ah, spell. Track scent. Allows the caster to trace creatures that have recently passed through an area. Two black magic. And again, the weeks are just flying by now. Ooh. Spirit sight. Detects nearby sentience, including ghosts and creatures of the other world. That's interesting. Oh, and I also learned empathy. Reveals the emotional state of a target. At the appointed time, I make my way to the testing room. I'm not sure why they send us to a specific room anyway, if they're just going to teleport us into the dungeon when we get there. Unless this time it will be different? Nope, doesn't look like it. Oh. Once again, I find myself in the dungeon, but this time in a larger area, facing a deep, dark hole.
Greetings, cutie patootie! Behold the abyss! You will find the exit to this dungeon on the other side. This dungeon level is now warded. You may not teleport outside of this dungeon level. You must cross the abyss in order to succeed. You may choose to surrender at any time, and you will be retrieved from the dungeon safely. However, you will fail your exam and receive demerits. Good luck!
So, now what? Oh. Oh, I've got a health bar and a magic bar. Movement and spellcasting commands can be found on the left-hand side of the screen. If you hold down the shift key, you can use the left, right, and up arrows to move around the dungeon. Well, that's cool. Now, apparently, I can give up, but that doesn't actually give me detention, apparently. I need to actually, like, lose my health or lose all my magicka or something. So, let's see. Shift key. Oh. Could it be that simple? Well, if I make it, I guess I'm gonna have to reload and try and fail again. But if I don't make it, that long drop should probably take my health out. Okay, here goes nothing. Jumping. I take a few steps back, then get a running start and leap. But not far enough. Ah! Oh. But instead of splattering, I find myself back in the school. Thank you, sir.
Miss Patootie, what did you think you were doing?
Being adventurous, sir.
Smashing yourself to pieces is your idea of an adventure?
I'm sorry. The hole might have been an illusion. Don't be so angry with me. My friend told me to do this.
Then use what little sense you possess to attempt to dispel it. And do not assume that I will always be there to catch you when you fall.
No.
For your abysmal performance, you will receive 10 demerits and detention tomorrow.
Yes, sir. Demerits. Ma.
Well, that stinks. I hope this detention is freaking worth it.
Because I was looking forward to actually doing something there.
On Saturday morning, I get up terribly early and deliver the mail and the allowances, and then I have to serve my detention.
Do, 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 do. Happy music for detention day, everybody!
I am the first to arrive in the detention room. Followed shortly by Donald.
Oh, hey, man.
You screwed up your exam, too.
Exam?
Well, isn't that why you're here?
No, why are you here?
Never mind. The professor arrives and looks back and forth at the two of us.
Mr. Danson, what could I do that would make you stop ending up here every weekend?
I don't know.
This is a serious question, Mr. Danson. I require a truthful answer.
What if you didn't like the answer? I mean, if the truth made you mad and you gave me another detention, then...
You will not be punished for speaking the truth. I have ways to tell if you are lying. If you are, I may have to become creative.
Well, okay.
He thinks for a moment,
then smiles.
If you climbed up on the cafeteria table during lunch wearing a feather boa and sang happy birthday to me.
I'd love to see this. Someone draw a picture of this.
That would cause you to stop seeking out detention.
Yes.
Your honesty is duly noted.
I will show you to your task. Follow me. Miss Patootie, wait here.
They leave the room.
I'm not sure what Donald was thinking, but I bet the professor's not happy with him.
He looks quite put out.
A few minutes later, Professor Grabiner returns. He sits at the table and massages his temples.
Sir?
Oh, you. Yeah, me. He stands and turns to go through one of the cabinets until he finds a thin book which he tosses onto the table.
Read that. Write a report summarizing it.
I pick up the book. It's hardcover with a patterned gold binding and a crudely drawn scowling figure on the front. The title is Little Will Went Up the Hill and Came Down in Pieces. Is this the, magical version of Jack and Jill?
Is this a children's book?
If you behave like a child, you will be educated like one. This is how wizard children learned not to be suicidally stupid. Now get started.
He's got quite a sense of humor, actually. I find that very funny, actually.
Keeping my side to myself, I sit down and begin reading.
Wow, this is morbid. Every few pages, one of Willie's friends makes a mistake and dies in a grisly new way, while the adults in the background carry on having a party.
British kids have to read this stuff?
Can't you just spank me?
I love my friend so much right now.
How is he gonna react to this, though? It's gotta be good. I mean, she wouldn't steer me wrong. Yes. We're going for it, guys.
Can't you just spank me and get it over with?
Weird points.
You want me to spank you?
Yes, please. Never mind. I feel if I'm too enthusiastic about this idea, he'll be like, I'm gonna slap you, girl, in the face, though. Or give me, like, even more detention or more merits or something. Let's not be too obvious. Played a little closer to the chest this time.
Well, I don't want to stay here all day writing a creepy book report.
I'd rather be punished quickly so I can leave.
Oh!
Blushing! There's a little blushy blush on the cheeks.
For several long moments, he stares at me and says nothing.
Since the object of this lesson is to teach you to value your own skin, I suppose the application of pain would be relevant.
He's gonna actually do it, everybody. And he's got a smile for it, too.
Stand up, bend over, and put your hands on the table.
He's really going to do it?
I stand up and spread my hands against the table surface, feeling the slight stickiness of sweat on my palms. He's behind me somewhere. I can't see. My robe swishes against the back of my legs as I shift nervously, waiting.
Yow! What was that? What was that? That wasn't a hand. Ouch!
A second stripe of pain flares and vanishes just as quickly.
The heck is he using? A whip?
How is he doing that? I don't hear anything moving through the air. I don't feel anything touching me.
Oh, was he using a spank spell? Ow!
I look up from the table as Professor Grabiner walks back into my field of vision. Some of the tests you will face may be dangerous. You may face monsters in combat. You may receive injuries.
Again, something unseen strikes me from behind.
Much worse than this.
Yes, sir.
We will do our best to preserve your life, but you must be prepared to look after yourself. Every witch and wizard must be strong enough to uphold their duties.
Yes, sir.
You may go.
I earned the naughty trophy.
I love it. Feeling slightly embarrassed and slightly sore, I make my way back to my dorm early.
It was totally worth it, guys. It was totally worth it. What happened to my date? My date's gone. Cutie, there you are. Oh, hi, Minnie. Minnie runs up to me in the hall.
I need you to sign off on the orders for the dark dance.
The what?
On Halloween, it's a ceremony. I can find you a book about it.
That's okay. What do you need me for?
Each class contributes to part of the setup. We're doing incense. I've already picked some out, but I need you to sign to authorize the funds.
That's all?
Everything else is taken care of. I've got the papers here, so if you can just sign.
I should talk to Professor Grabiner. Hold on. I'm gonna save here, and I want to fix this date, so I'm just gonna reload. Hold on a second. Okay, so I couldn't figure out anything on the internet about how to fix that, so I guess I'm just gonna have to hope that it fixes itself. Otherwise, I guess the date's not really that important. I'll just have to, go by what the characters tell me, I guess. Also, I made myself some tea, so if there's a long pause, it's because I'm sipping it. Anyway, yes, I'm gonna go talk to Professor Grabiner, because I want to spend some time with him. I don't think I should sign anything without knowing more about it. I should really talk to Professor Grabiner.
If you say so.
I don't really think she'd make up a story just to steal class funds, but it wouldn't be responsible of me to give money away for no reason, would it? I'll find you later so we can finish this.
Alright.
After a bit of looking, I find Professor Grabiner in one of the classrooms, scribbling in a large book that he always carries with him.
Can I help you, Miss Patuti?
Minnie wanted me to authorize some purchases for the dark dance.
And are you not capable of taking the simple action on your own?
I've never heard of the dark dance. I don't know what's appropriate.
Ah.
He closes the book and clears his throat.
You are familiar with the traditions of All Hallows and the festivals for the dead?
I know Halloween.
Many cultures hold that at this time of year, the boundaries between our world and the other world grow thin, allowing spirits and monsters to cross the veil. The dark dance is a local custom in which spirits are invited to take part in celebration with mortals as equals. It is held in the dark, thus the name, so that no one can see who or what is in attendance. Do not attempt to get around that provision. Spirit folk are bound by many rules. Those who break the rules are punished harshly.
Yes, sir.
The ceremony will take place on Halloween night and last until 3 a.m. Classes will be cancelled on the following day to allow time to recover. As for the choice of incense, I have no particular expertise. You should consult with Miss Cochran.
Yes, sir.
I suppose I could have just agreed with her to begin with. Well, I can go and find her again now.
Okay, that week's over. Diary. Classes, 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 and then the plunge of doom. I tried to think outside the box by jumping over the hole instead of using magic. It didn't work, and now I've got detention.
Spanking?
Best part of the week so far. Professor Grabiner punished me for taking what he considered to be foolish risks in the dungeon exam. That was totes worth it. Dark dance preparations. Minnie needed me to authorize some purchases for a Halloween ceremony, so I asked Professor Grabiner to tell me about it. And so we got to know each other a little bit more.